the Consumer Electronics Show in Berlin officially kicks off today. Thanks for joining us here on IDG Daily. I'm Nick Barber. It's Friday, September 2nd. Before we get to what we'll be covering today, let's take a quick recap of yesterday's news. We heard from Samsung, and among other things, they launched a gadget called the Galaxy Note, a 5.3-inch smartphone-tablet hybrid that uses a stylus. We had a chance to catch up with an analyst and ask him whether or not he thought it would be successful.
I think the Galaxy Note is kind of an interesting product. In some ways, it's sort of a throwback, right? It's a 5-inch phone with a stylus. It almost feels like a PDA. The reality is large phones have never done particularly well. The Dell Streak didn't do particularly well. I think Samsung's going to be pretty challenged with this product. Not sure that people really miss the stylus.
Toshiba also had a tablet along with an Ultrabook. Now, Ultrabooks are a new name trademarked by Intel, and Intel gives specific hardware configurations in order for it to be called an Ultrabook. And those are under 20 millimeters thick, 5 to 8+ hours of battery life, a solid-state disk, a Core i5 or i7 processor, among others. Toshiba meets or exceeds all of those, and Ultrabooks are designed for consumers that want a powerful, lightweight laptop with more functionality than a tablet. Coming up today, we'll swing by Sony's booth and take a look at a 3D head-mounted display. We'll also talk to Fraunhofer. Now, that might not be a name you're familiar with, but they had a hand in creating the format MP3. They'll also have a lot of really interesting research projects here at IFA. And finally, we'll go over to LG, which has an iPhone-controlled vacuum that takes photos of its progress. For IDG Daily on Friday, September 2nd, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service, Berlin.